Terry O has asked us for an alternative colour scheme for painting Brayherd fur, so today we're going to show you a really nice method for painting a red-brown colour scheme. Now for this, a great undercoat is a Mechanica Standard Grey, and then we're going to start out by base coating all of the fur and the flesh at the same time using Doomball Brown. Then we're going to block in all the fur with Rhinox Hide before shading all over the miniature with Agrax Earthshade. After that, to highlight the fur, we're going to dry brush it using Sylvaneth Bark, and then for the flesh, we're going to need Tuscor Fur. But we're going to be starting out with Doomball Brown, which I'm going to be applying using my large base brush. And as always, you want to use your palette to get your paint ready, thinning it down with a little bit of water. Being careful with this size of brush because it does tend to absorb water very quickly. You don't want to overdo it as you're mixing it on your palette. So you're looking for it to be kind of like this. And once you've got that ready, all you need to do is start applying this all over your miniature. And you can see this colour works really well over that Mechanica Standard Grey undercoat. So just apply it evenly like this, also giving it two thin coats just to make sure it's an even finish before you move on to the next step. Once you've finished painting the miniature with Doomball Brown, you're then ready to move on to Rhinox Hide, thinned down a little bit and painted onto all the fur like this, using a medium layer brush. The next step is to apply a coat of Agrax Earthshade all over both the fur and the flesh. And once you've done so, give the miniature plenty of time to dry. About half an hour will be fine. Once the shade is completely dry, we're ready to begin highlighting. And first of all, we're going to highlight all the fur using Sylvaneth Bark. Now, dry brush this on with a small dry brush, being very light and selective like this, just to catch the texture of the fur. As you're doing it, you need to be careful around the flat parts of the flesh. For example, just around here, you see I'm just being as selective as I can, just to keep it on that textured fur. And finally, we're now ready to highlight all the flesh using Tuscor Fur. For this, you need a small airbrush, and all we're looking to do is to paint some sharper lines following along the most defined features of the skin. So for example, going around the head here, you can see I'm picking out the snout and the nose just there, around the mouth, just on the cheekbone just there, all features like this to make these details stand out a little bit more. And with that, the flesh and the fur is completed, ready for those smaller remaining details to be painted in. So Terry, I really hope you like this colour scheme and I hope it helps you out as well. And we'll see you all again very soon.